Hello. A lot of videos and websites talk about how can we list the sheet's name in a range of cells with or without macros. I'll give you a new way that no one talked about, by only using Excel functions. I will use cell, text join, left, right, len, find, indirect, and more functions. So stay with me on that. But before starting, if you are new to my channel, hit that subscribe button, drop a like, and leave a comment. Are you ready? Let's begin. Here I have an Excel workbook called Accounts Receivable, and it contains a set of worksheets, each with the name of a customer. I also have a worksheet for indexing, and I have to put the names of customers on it with their balances. If we go to the first customer worksheet, the customer's name must appear in cell H5. To select the worksheets that contain the customer's data, press the Shift button and then click on the last sheet. Thus, we can edit all the worksheets at once. Then I'll go to any cell I want, for example G1. I will write the following formula, equals cell. The wanted factor is file name, comma. The reference will be A1 cell. Here the file name will appear with where it's saved in the file browser, followed by the name of the active worksheet. We note here that the delimiter between the file name and the name of the worksheet is the right square bracket. In order to know its arrangement among the characters in a cell, we must use the find function. In G2 cell, for example, let's write equals find, right square bracket between two quotation marks, comma, find the order of the square bracket in cell G1. The value here is 50, but it's variable. I'll come back to it shortly. To find the number of characters in cell G1, we have to use the len function, equals len G1. The value here is 61, it's also variable. If we count the worksheet name characters including spaces, it will be equal to the residual between len and find. Now, let's use write function. To get the name of the worksheet within cell H5, we will write equals write. The text here is G1 cell, comma. The number of characters required is G3 minus G2. If we move between the worksheets, we will find that each worksheet has its name in cell H5. Now, in cell H5 formula, we want to replace each cell with its formula to be independent by itself. We will repeat this process a lot in this video, so please focus with me. In G1, let's select the formula without equal sign and copy it. In G2, replace G1 with the formula we copied. In G3, just like that. In H5, we will replace the three cells in the same way. I'm going to copy the formula into cell G2 without the equal sign and put it instead of G2 in cell H5. The same I will do for G3 in the cell H5. We can use find and replace instead. I will explain that in this video. Now, delete these items because I don't need them. All worksheets are ready now. I'll be using sheet function to help me in lookup in the index sheet. In any cell, like G1, let's write equals sheet. It will give me the order of the worksheet in an Excel workbook, and it will change according to the order of each worksheet. I will combine the sheet function with H5 cell with AND symbol. Here we will find that the name of the worksheet will be followed by its order without any delimiter. Now we will turn to the index worksheet. We want the names of sheets to appear in the index sheet. First, we'll use text join equals text join. Choose any delimiter like columns, comma. Here we have two choices, true for ignore empty cells, false for include empty cells. There is no difference between the two cases in our example. Let's select true, comma. Go to the first customer worksheet and select cell G1. Then press the shift button, and on the last customer worksheet, press F4 to be with absolute reference. Then press enter. We have the names of all worksheets with their orders in the workbook, separated by columns, and we want to separate them in these cells. For the first one, we will use left function equals left. The text here is A1, comma. The number of characters is find function, find 2, comma, A1, enter. To get rid of 2, we put minus 1 after the parentheses of the find function, enter. Don't forget that we want A1 with absolute reference, so we turn back to the formula and press on A1 and then press F4. To dynamic lookup for numbers, we want row function in A3 write equals row A2. The result is 2. Let's find it in A1 cell. Turn back to the formula. After equal sign write, find. At the end of the formula write comma. A1. The result is 12, which means that number 2 is 12th character. In B3 we write equals row. The result is 3. The same steps to find it in A1. The result here is 27. Let's subtract A3 from B3 and the result will be 15. Now we want the mid function to separate the other worksheets names equals mid. The text is A1 with absolute reference. The order of the first character we want to extract in text is A3. The number of characters we want returns is C3. To remove colons and 2, we'll add 2 to A3. Enter. We know that 3 and colons will appear. To remove them, subtract 2 from C3. Enter. As we did before, we will replace cell references with their formula content. I'll start with cell C3. We replace B3 with the formula it contains by copying and pasting. As well as A3. Then in D3 we replace A3 with its formula and C3 too. Cut D3 and paste in A3. Delete these cells because I don't need them anymore. fill a series down, all worksheets names will appear. We will also have errors after the worksheets are finished, but there's no problem. I'll get rid of them later. We want now to replace A1 with its formula. Select and copy the formula without equal sign. From Home tab, find and select Replace. In Find What field, write $A, then 1. For that, I put A1 with absolute reference in all formulas. In Replace with field, paste the formula. Press Replace or Replace All. After finishing, press Close. Delete A1 cell content. Trap errors with if error. After equal sign, write if error. At the end of the formula, write comma, then 2 quotation marks. Repeat these steps in A3 cell. Fill series down. Here we're done. Let me see if I create a new sheet. What will happen? If I go to any sheet like Dexter Belly Sheet, right click on the mouse, move or copy, create a copy. I have to move it after the second sheet and before the last sheet. Its name will appear in the index worksheet. Don't use number in the sheet's names to avoid any potential error. If I rename the worksheet, its name will change in the index worksheet. I want to make links for all worksheets and take balances for all customers. To do that, I want to use indirect and hyperlink functions. Let's see how. For example, if I want the value of A1 in John Hughes worksheet, I write equals and go to John Hughes worksheet, then press on A1. Enter. To show the formula, write apostrophe before equals sign. As we see, if the cell or cells to be referenced are on another worksheet within the same workbook, precede the cell or range reference with the name of the worksheet followed by an exclamation point and enclose with apostrophes. If we want to get the same text but based on the content of cell A2, write equals. Then apostrophe between 2 quotation marks and symbol A2 and symbol, then apostrophe and exclamation point and A1 between 2 quotation marks. Press enter. We get the same text we want. Let's select and copy the formula and paste it in B2. If we precede the formula with a hash after the first quotation mark, the text is ready for hyperlink function. Write hyperlink after equals. The link location is our text, comma. Friendly name is optional. The jump text or numeric value that is displayed in the cell. Here we want A2. If we delete the friendly name, the alt text will be displayed in the cell, so let's turn it back. If we fill series down, the sheet's name will be displayed, and we will have a link to every sheet in our file. For the formula to be independent, we need to replace A2 with its contents and A3 also. Go to A2, select and copy the formula without equals. Go to B2. Replace A2 with copied formula. Press enter. Select and copy the formula in B2. Paste it in A2. The link is in A2 now. Repeat the same steps in A3 and B3 because we have another formula here. Go to A3. Select and copy the formula without equals. Go to B3, replace A3 with copied formula. Press Enter. Double click in B3 or click in the formula bar. Ctrl plus A to select all formula. Copy. Double click in A3 or click in the formula bar. Ctrl plus A to select all formula. Paste. Fill series down. Format Painter if necessary. The links are ready in column A. Delete cells contents in column B because we don't need them. Again, format Painter. Let's move C2 content to B2. Just by drag and drop. If we filter it down, the sheet name will change. Actually, we need the value of cell H11 to get the balance of each customer. This sheet was designed in a previous video. I'll put the link in the description. Let's go back to the index worksheet. Then we replace A1 with H11. Then let's precede the text with the indirect function. We got our first customer balance. If we fill series down, we get the balance for each customer. Let's change the number format to accounting. Let's write titles for our table. Account name. Balance. Debit between two parentheses / credit to express that the debit balance is negative and the credit balance is positive. Then we do some formatting for the cells. The file is ready with all the names of the worksheets, each with a link that takes me to it. I think the formulas was a little bit complicated. But here, we didn't use any macros or codes. And we get a dynamic range of worksheets names. That's all for today. If you like this video, please share it to benefit as many people as possible. See you soon.